iodine specialist Iofina has confirmed that it has now completed a $20 million debt restructuring. Now, this removes uncertainty over its balance sheet and opens up a fresh $10 million facility. It's also released its latest results. I am joined on the phone now by the chief executive, Dr. Tom Becker. So in terms of the facility, Tom, you know, how does this tie in with your strategy? What are you going to spend the money on?
So right now we're not going to be drawing on the facility as yet, but it will help with our future growth plans. Right now we have five current iodine producing plants and an iodine chemical company. We're looking at growth plans, especially on the production side, and the increased facility that we now have in place will allow us the flexibility to be able to execute those growth plans in the future.
So in terms of production, Tom, you know, in terms of your results, what's quite significant is that in terms of the price, operationally, you performed well, but this was undermined by the lower price of iodine.
Yeah, we've done a good job over the last 2+ years of getting our production to a level where we are consistent in our production and we've lowered costs significantly. What we can't control is iodine prices, and that definitely affects not only the top line, but the bottom line for the company as well.
Okay, I mean, obviously the iodine price is out of your control, but what's the forecast for the iodine price based on the fundamentals?
Yeah, it's a little bit difficult to say because the iodine market is definitely growing. Applications for iodine, including healthcare, pharmaceuticals, biocides, LCD screens are all in growth pattern. However, there is still seem to be a little bit of excess iodine in the market. Some of the iodine suppliers are competing for market share, and that's still driving down price. We don't anticipate this to happen much further, and these prices are well below historical trends of iodine prices. But to be honest, we have to just control what Iofina can control, and that's our production and our costs. And we have to manage the business knowing the market is in a somewhat depressed state with respect to iodine prices at this point.
Okay, but even so, you've just given us some examples of the various applications that iodine can be used for. So you still anticipate that you're in a growth market? And if so, how does this impact the future outlook for the company?
Yeah, so iodine growth this year, we expect to be between about 3 to 4% worldwide on iodine consumption. And we expect that to be the same way moving forward in the last few years. Iodine market has been a pretty steady growing market for the last 20 years, and we don't anticipate that changing in the future. So that gives us a lot of opportunities, not only with our iodine production, but also the derivatives that we make out of iodine to be able to take advantage of that growth in the marketplace.
So finally, Tom, I understand in the last results that some records were made for the company.
Yeah, we were able to really increase our revenue despite iodine prices going down. Our production is very steady. We now have this debt facility in place to be able to increase our production and become even the larger producer of iodine in the United States. And we're very happy with our growth, and we look forward to updating the market soon.
Thank you very much, Dr. Tom Becker, Chief Executive of Iofina. Thank you very much indeed.
My pleasure. Thank you.